Hi everyone, today I'm at the Newmarket Road Test Examination Center, and we're gonna do the G2 road test. We're gonna show you the full route and give you tips and tricks so that you can pass your test right from the first time. Let's go. It's a good idea to park your car backwards like this, so when you start, you go forward. Hello everyone, so I'm here in the car getting ready for the G2 road test, and again I'm here with a friend who's gonna give us all the tips and tricks so we can pass this from the first time.
Hello everybody, here we are in the Newmarket Examination Center for G2 road test. When you checked in the center, you come to your car, you sit down, you wait for examiner. Examiner usually come and ask to verify your ID, what's your name, what's your address, make sure you know your postal code. And then they ask you to start the car and go around the car for circle check. Make sure all your lights are working, signal left, right, brake lights. Make sure you have no cracks on your windshield. Make sure you have full gas, full tank of gas. And your tires are in good thread. And then examiner sit down in your car and ask if you're ready, let's go to the right. Make sure you buckle up, make sure you use your parking brake all the time when you stop your car. And if you're ready, let's go right. Sometimes we have here cars, sometimes pedestrians. Make sure it's clear. If you have some pedestrians or cars, wait. And let's go for G2. This stop sign, we turning left. Stop sign only for us. We turning left to Harry Walker Parkway. Harry Walker Parkway, it's speed limit 50 kilometers per hour here. And we're going straight till traffic light, and first coming traffic light, we turning left. It's Gorham Street. Gorham Street is a small street, again with speed limit 50 kilometers per hour. Make sure you check your mirror, signal, blind spot for pedestrians. It's a one lane for us street here. We're going straight till Leslie. Leslie, it's a big street, it's a major street here in Newmarket. It's two lanes each way, and speed limit on Leslie is 60, but here on Gorham we have 50. When you're going on the road test, you have to control your speed constantly. From time to time, you check in your rear view and speed limit control. This coming traffic light, we turning right to Leslie. You remember we can make a right turn on red signal after full stop. Your stop should be before stop line. Check your blind spot for pedestrians. Here on Leslie we have speed limit is 60, and we're going straight. We're gonna go straight, couple of traffic lights, maybe three traffic lights. Examiner will ask you to make a lane change. Left, right, left, right. They want you to make sure that you're comfortable with lane changes. It's not too much traffic in here, but sometimes we have some cars. some people might go much faster than 60. Sometimes you're keeping distance with the car in front of you, and this car in front of you starts speeding up, but make sure you not follow this car too fast. So control your speed constantly. Okay, change your lane left, please, if it's safe. Okay, when you're changing your lane, after you're changing your lane, your car should be completely in a new lane, and then you off your signal. Don't off your signal too early. Let your car be completely in a new lane. We're crossing Davis Drive. Nice weather today. Road tests, they perform road tests practically in any weather, unless it's like too much snow and snowstorm. But when it's in summertime, when it's raining, you're gonna have your road test. It's sometimes it's a little bit different to drive when it's dry road or when it's a raining day. And when it's raining, it's we have to make some more precautions. So if you're interested to know how to drive in the rainy weather, we have video, so check it out. It's gonna be helpful for us, for you guys. Okay, and change your lane right, please, when it's safe. Speed limit is 60. Okay, when you're changing your lane, control your speed. This traffic light going straight. Okay, let's make a lane change to the left, even if it's safe. Okay, this coming traffic light, we're going straight. We're going straight till next traffic light. Next traffic light is Jagaras. Street called Jagaras, and then you're gonna turn left. Okay. Jacaranda Drive, we're turning left in residential area. It's calm residential area where examiner will ask you to make a 3-point turn, parallel parking, downhill or uphill parking, one of them. Okay. So Jacaranda, speed limit is 40 begins here. It's nice, calm, wavy drive. But keep your speed 40. We're going straight. A little bit. Check your rear view. Speed limit is confirming 40 kilometers per hour. We're going straight till first stop sign, and first stop sign we're gonna turn right. It's a always stop. You remember, it's a first come, first go. You make sure you complete full stop, no movement at all. Okay, first come, first go. This is Janet Street. We're going straight till stop sign and first coming stop sign, we're turning right to Varata Avenue. This stop sign only for us. Make sure no cars from left and right. And examiner asks you, okay, pull over to the right and make your parking. Park your car right here. They're not gonna say you it's uphill parking or downhill parking. You have to see it by yourself. So it's an uphill road here. Arm brake. Yeah, you remember when it's uphill, you turn your wheels left out of the curb.
The other way?
The other way. Not towards the curb, but out of the curb. Uphill with the curb, you have to...
Uphill is to the right, downhill is to the left?
No, opposite. So this is uphill, left, downhill, or flat road is right. So turn the wheels left, all the way left. Okay, let's go straight.
So what happens if you make this mistake?
It's up to examiner, but... Usually it's not a big mistake. Examiner will understand that you're a little bit nervous or excited about your road test. You know that you have to turn your wheels, but you mixed up left and right. It's like, I think it's not the crucial mistake.
Okay.
Okay, let's make a parallel parking with this car.
What if there is a car behind? You still
wait?
Going?
Make a signal right, wait for this car. Wait for this car to pass, and then you're gonna make a parallel parking. Okay. When you're making parallel parking, there should be no cars in front, no cars behind. If you have some cars, wait. Let them go first, and then you're gonna make a parallel parking. And when you're making parallel parking, and it's not on a flat road, but uphill or downhill, you also have to turn your wheels left or right. So this one is uphill. Parallel parking with uphill.
Left, parking, brake.
Okay, that's good. Let's get out from here.
Signal, left.
Okay, let's make a 3-point turn. And you remember, guys, when you're making 3-point turn, from this point you're going back to examination center, pretty same road. Make sure no cars in front, no cars behind, no pedestrians. You check your blind spots. If you have some cars, wait, don't be in rush, but don't be too slow. You have to practice 3-point turn before the road test. Make it like 50 times and you're gonna be comfortable. You have to be a little bit overconfident when you're going to the road test, because on the road test you become nervous or excited, and that's why when people making mistakes. This stop sign, we're going straight, and from Varata Avenue we're turning back to Janet, turning left. no stop sign here, no oncoming traffic, no pedestrians. We're turning without stop. And this coming stop sign, we're turning left to Jacaranda Drive. Speed limit is 40 kilometers per hour on Jacaranda. And we're going back toward Leslie. And through Leslie, we're going back to examination center.
40 here. Oh,
40 here. Altogether, time on the road test is gonna be around maybe 10 minutes, maybe 12 minutes if you stop a couple times on traffic light. You stop on traffic light and if it's red, you lost a minute or you lost a couple minutes if you stop twice or three times. But length of your road test is usually 12 minutes, maximum 15. Okay, going straight. Speed limit is 40. You control your speed constantly, checking your rear view and this coming traffic light, it's Leslie Street, we're turning right. Leslie is a big major street, speed limit is 60, some cars might go even faster than 60 easily. So keep attention on this. Here's the speed limit sign, 60 maximum, accelerate. Going straight. Checking your left, right when you're crossing intersections. Examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left. If it's safe, don't be in rush, check everything. If it's safe, perform a lane change. And we're going straight, maybe three traffic lights.
This feels longer than downsview.
Yeah, downsview is a shorter probably. When you start your road test with examiner, after 20 minutes examiner will have another student for the road test. So usually it's like 15 minutes maximum for them to perform the road test. After 15 minutes, they have to be back in examination center. This traffic light, we're going straight. Next one is Davis Drive. And we're gonna go straight again. When you stop on traffic light, make sure you keep your distance with the car in front of you. It should be not too close. It should be enough room to escape if this car in front of you stuck here. So always leave your distance in front to escape from this situation, this position. Usually examiners not talking too much, usually they only give directions, just make left, make right, and all this stuff. But sometimes they're gonna ask you maybe some other questions, but usually it's just all about business. Okay, we're going straight till first traffic light after Davis Drive, and first coming traffic light, we're gonna turn left. There will be additional lane for left turn. Yeah, This light, we turn in left. Stockhouse Road. If no cars, no pedestrians, you check your blind spot. If everything is clear, we turn in left. And here we have no speed limit signs. We assume it's 50 kilometers per hour. If some cars in front of you going slowly, just keep distance, follow this car. Some of them might go like 30 kilometers per hour or something. Just be patient, keep going, keep distance in front. From time to time you check in your rear view, rear mirror, just to know if somebody behind of you, just know to know situation on the road. And first coming stop sign, we turn in right. It's Harry Walker Parkway, where our examination center is located. Turning right and going back to examination center. It's a one lane, and here's additional lane for bicyclists. So I didn't see many bicyclists right here, but sometimes we have some. So keep attention for them. This traffic light is Gorham. We're gonna go straight, and after this traffic light we turning right to examination center on the parking lot. Examiner will ask you to make a probably reverse parking or maybe front in parking. Front in parking should be with one shot, with one try. And you have to park your car exactly in between lanes. If you feel or if you can see it's not good parking, go back and forth to fix your position. It should be nice. It should be enough room for you to get out of the car and enough room for examiner to get out of the car. Speed limit is 50. On the parking lot of examination center, sometimes we have excited people running back and forth. Kids or like examiners pay attention not only for cars but for pedestrians. Sometimes they don't even see you if they're running. Okay, wait. Okay, let's go straight and let's make a reverse parking on the right side. You start the road test from the left side, but when you're coming back, it's gonna be on the right side, parking on the right side. Here's no numbers, but let's make a reverse parking beside this blue car. Park your car, off your engine. This is the end of your road test.
Okay.
Off your car. Okay.
Did I pass? So
yeah,
nervous.
You pass. Yeah. You mixed up with uphill parking or downhill parking, but like, yeah, the rest was good. Another one mistake was when you start changing lane for left turn to Stockhouse, you enter a little bit early. There was a double solid yellow lane. It's a good idea to go exactly when it started broken lane for left. For the left turn. The rest was good.
Okay. So that was G2 road test here in Newmarket. If your road test is in the other examination center, like Metro East or DownSU, we have videos for those as well. So check them out. And I hope you found this useful. There's also a video in this examination center for G-Full. So if you're going for G-Full, watch that video. And if you like this video, consider subscribing, sharing, liking. And we wish you all the best on your road test. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.